back of the Chewy, all of those dishes that they really stick out in our minds, the ones that taste, that they roll your eyes back in your head, they're delicious. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right, well, our next guest is a dear friend of mine, one of the most amazing chefs. He was a kind of rock star celebrity chef long before it was cool. And I'm very excited that he's cooking with us here today, my buddy Jonathan Waxman.
Jonathan Waxman isn't just your average chef. He's a Jedi master. Nicknamed the Obi-Wan of the food world, he skillfully guided and advised some of the country's greatest chefs. His successful NYC restaurant, Barbudo, serves up one of the most acclaimed chicken dishes in America. And now he's putting his stamp on the south of the border cuisine as culinary advisor at Rosa Mexicano. With two cookbooks, countless awards, and a successful stint on Top Chef Masters under his hat, Jonathan Waxman is a true legend in the culinary world.
I love this man so much, and he is truly one of the great chefs of America because what he does is so simple, and that's what I love about your food so much.
Thank you so much. So we're gonna have a little bit of fun today. You know, it's springtime, and right. I love lamb. I grew up actually on a farm in Sonoma County, and the greatest thing in the world was having spring lamb. And the best bits were these lamb chops. And you know, when I cook a little bit of Italian food in my restaurant, Barbudo, I'm a little too cheap. I don't do lamb chops in the restaurant. All we do is we either do legs of lamb and stuff like that. But I thought for you, Michael, lamb chops
Thank
today.
You. You know, it's a special day.
So these guys are grilling over here. And lamb chops are funny. You don't do it too high a temperature. If you do, otherwise they kind of burn. In fact, in Italy, they do it a little bit slower on a very low coals that gets nice and crispy. It takes a little bit longer. You want to render the fat
cooks,
a little
yeah,
bit.
It cooks all
yeah,
the way
it gets
through.
kind of really kind of crispy and beautiful, and that salt gets up inside. It's just wonderful.
Now Wax, today's show, we're talking about fried stuff. And one of my favorite things ever is the fried potatoes you do at Barbudo. I've actually stolen them, and they're on most of my menus now, too.
I won't charge you, Michael.
I put JW's fried potatoes. I feel that that's safe, then.
Well, then maybe you should get it. Give me a nickel each time, you know?
Yeah, so how do you make these?
It's so easy, and this is kind of cute. These obviously are organic because they're so tiny. They're normal russet potatoes. You know, any other potato really doesn't work for this. This is the greatest thing to do at home. You just cook these in a steamer, or you boil them for about 40 minutes or
so. Just so they're fork tender.
Yeah, yep. And then what we're going to do is we're going to crush them.
All right.
So let's do it on here so we don't make a big mess. It literally just...
It's okay. We have people that'll clean up.
That's all right.
But Taylor will jump in here and he'll tidy the whole place up.
So, Michael, you know, the last time we did this, you didn't do that great a job. Okay?
Okay, get it.
So, Michael, watch me this time.
Oh, yes, yes,
Chef. Last you squish too hard. We're going to gently break these up here.
Don't go all Danielle Ballou on me today.
All right.
Just
so,
gently.
Yeah, like nice and light there, buddy.
See?
Okay. Beautiful.
Men
and
food.
I'm going to give these guys a little turn.
Now, right in.
Right in.
So you have the oil at what, 325?
325.
These get all crunchy on the outside.
And this is beautiful. So they're starting to
oh, that was okay, his. That was you. That was his.
That's all right. We're good on that.
Oh, God. Battali, come clean this up.
And the thing to be careful at home, and I would suggest.
He's great, isn't he?
Mario, I need those.
They've been rendered non-usable.
All right, so
while those are frying, show me what you're going to make.
Now, this is a recipe that I actually stole from my buddy Alice Waters at Chez Panisse. And she is the genius of all genius in the food world. And it's a guacamole made with fava beans. Springtime. Ooh. And, I really love this recipe. You're going to chop up some mint there for me. I'm going to put a little bit of garlic in here.
You just want this rough chopped?
Just like that. It's perfect. Right. A little bit of scallions and a little bit of jalapeno chilies. Oh.
Some heat.
Wow.
Some heat. And, Michael, let's put the mint in first.
Oh,
okay, mint first, if you don't mind. And then, Michael, do me a favor. Put a little salt in there.
All right. A little olive oil.
A little bit of olive oil. See, these guys are ready to go here.
Oh, those look beautiful.
Right. And then just dump them in there. And here's our implement of destruction. Ready to go?
Yes.
So this is... I love this.
Oh, you could do this with peas, too.
You can do it with peas. You can actually mix them together.
How about avocados? Could you use avocados?
That's a great idea.
I don't know what I was thinking. I don't know where I was going.
Where did that come from?
Divine inspiration.
I do a little consulting for Rosa Mexicana, and they use avocados. They do a really good job. I didn't want to, like, usurp them today. So here we go. So put a little lemon in for me.
All right. So we're going to continue to mash these.
We're going to mash these guys up.
And when we get back, we're going to put the whole dish together.
The whole thing together.
And
the potatoes are beautifully browning up here. Look at those.
All right, you guys. Jonathan's going to finish up the potatoes. We're going to be back in a sec. Don't go anywhere. All right, everybody, welcome back to The Chew. As you can see, it's been all about frying stuff today. Jonathan's got his potatoes coming out of the oil. Look at them. They're crunchy and delicious.
This is so easy to do, Michael. Oh. I mean, it's like, it's really a no-brainer.
I know. I stole them. I make them at the restaurants all the
time. But, you know, at home, you can do them in the oven, too. All you do is put them in a bowl, toss them a little bit, like a half cup of oil, toss them really fast, put them in the oven for about 40 minutes, 375, 400 degrees. It's a no-brainer. Take them out. Oh. Drain them a little bit.
On top.
A little cheese.
For breakfast.
Look at that. Oh,
nothing better than Parmesan cheese for breakfast.
Oh, my God. So good. And look, the lamb chops are beautiful. This little fava guacamole is perfect.
You want to do the potatoes, and I'll do the olive oil?
Yeah.
Let's do it.
So the favas you could do with a masher, but you could also put them in a little, you know,
blender, whatever you want to do. The beauty of the fava beans, look at the color of them. It's just gorgeous.
Yeah.
You know? And it really is springtime, and fava beans, they're so delicious, but they're amazingly good for you. They're the healthiest thing you could possibly eat.
Mm, green food. Now, Wax, are either of these recipes, you have this beautiful new book, Italian My Way.
They're actually in the Italian My Way book. I actually do T-bone lamb chops, which I adore.
Oh, I do, too.
And they're marinated, and they're really... Thank you, Mario. And, you know, this is the way I cook at home, the way I cook at the restaurant. When we get together, that's how we cook.
Absolutely.
It's just getting really great ingredients, not mucking around too much, cook them simply, and if I had a knife and fork, I would eat.
No, I got that.
Wax, if you weren't a chef, what would you have done?
You know, I was a trombone player for a while, and I always loved, you know, playing music. But honestly, my secret desire, honestly, was to be a political science professor. That's what I would have preferred to be over anything else.
I am so happy you're a chef.
You know, but,
the university's loss was our gain.
You know, it's, you know, Mario, I think the thing about chefs is that, you know, we love to eat more than we love to cook.
Mm-hmm.
That, you know, it's like, I mean, it's obvious, you know, but...
I love both. I got to admit, I love both. And I mean, I love, like, the beauty of food and the beauty of the show, I think, is you show people really simple and easy dishes. You can make them, you sit around, you have a good time, you chat a little bit. I mean, that's what our life's like every day. We're very blessed people.
I think so. And you know what? The greatest reward at the end of the night is going home and having your wife have tacos ready, like last night. You know, my wife Sally came over and she had skirt steak tacos, chicken tacos, she had flour tortillas, corn tortillas, she had guacamole. I looked at her and said, really, honey? This is it? That was just remarkable.
Right. No. That's the beautiful life.
Thanks it for is coming on today.
I love you.
Thank you.
Really delicious. All right. That's all the time we have for today. Thanks for joining us. Tune in tomorrow because we're making the greatest meals in history. Have a great day today, everybody. See you back here tomorrow.